all we'd done would have enchanted me would have done in my place.
You were too modest, sir.
What would those guards want of me? And where is my husband?
Those guards were agents of the colony. The same agents that this afternoon conducted your husband with that speed.
My God, what has he done? He is innocence itself.
I believe his only crime is that he has the misfortune and the fortune to be your husband.
Then you know.
I know that you've been abducted. But how did you escape?
I've known since morning the reason for my abduction. And with the help of sheets, I let myself down.
But when?
I came home to tell my husband that the queen... But that is not my secret to tell. Therefore, I cannot tell you.
Pardon me, madame, but those men I drove away, they will return me free prisoners.
Yes, yes. Let us go.
Now, where should I conduct you?
I can't tell you. It's a secret.
My dear madame, Bonchon, your charming and most mysterious woman.
So you mistrust me?
On the contrary, I think you're a woman.
And now, this way.
Well,
where I go.
But where are you going?
See how we separate.
Do you see anyone there?
Perhaps, yes.
Perhaps, no. Who would be a man and a woman, Duchess?
I don't know yet.
Come on, Emma. I'm waiting for you to return.
I asked for the help of a gentleman, not a spy.
Spy? That's a harsh word.
What do you call a man who follows others in spite of their wishes?
Indiscreet.
The word is too mild. He is a spy.
I see that in his dirty wish.
You believe when I say so without blame to return?
Yes, on the faith of a gentleman. Be generous with me, madame. Confide in me. Can you not see anything but devotion in my eyes and sympathy in my heart?
But the secret is not mine to tell.
Then I will look into it for myself, since it will affect you.
Do not look into these matters. If you see me again, act as if you've never met me. I ask you this in the service you have already done for me, which I never shall forget.
If you could see into my heart, you'd find so much curiosity that you would pity me, and so much love that you'd instantly satisfy my curiosity. We have nothing to feel from those who love us.
You speak so suddenly, love, monsieur.
That is because love has come suddenly upon me, and for the first time, because I'm 20.
But by being seen of me, you risk imprisonment or death.
If that is true, I will never leave you.
Midnight is striking. I am expected.
I can refuse you nothing. I will depart.
I knew you were a good and brave man.
I wish I had never seen you.
I will not say as much. Someday I may satisfy your curiosity.
And someday will you satisfy my love?
It depends on the feelings you inspire in me.
You've been the same till now.
I cannot talk more. Be of good cheer. We'll meet again.
Oh, I am the happiest man in Paris.
Now go, go, in the name of heaven.
They are nothing to fear from those who love us. In your case, my friend, that may not be true.
Poor folks.
I'm sorry, I did not wish to interrupt what you would call flirting. So you saw her. Isn't she suitable? Suitable? She's a seamstress without 10 pistoles to call her on. She's in mortal danger, so she sends you away and says, be of good cheer, we'll meet again. Whatever she says makes absolutely no sense. So, she's perfectly suitable to be my friend. Athos. Athos has been arrested.
What for?
He was found in your lodging. They took him for it.
Why didn't he tell them his name?
He said D'Artagnan needs his liberty, not I. Well, he knows everything in my mind.
Bravo, Athos.
So then the officers took him and all your papers to the Bastille.
I cannot go home, for my house is being watched.
I want the captain to be, tell him all I know. I will find Aramis and meet you there.
I want to tell you when I see you again.
Yes, is it? Aramis, what's with the woman? Who is she?
She looks.
Whoa, what do you want, monsieur?
You're not Aramis.
No, I'm not Aramis. You may seem to mistake me for another. Pardon you.
You pardon me.
Yes, allow us to pass. It is not me. You have business.
You're right, monsieur. It is not with you that I have business. It is with four.
I read your word as a gentleman, you would not follow me.
I did not follow you. It was chance that put me in your path.
control.
You demand?
D'Artagnan!
I will know who you are!
Or you will die a senseless death.
In the name of heaven, my lord!
Wait! My lord? Pardon me, monsieur, but are you...
My lord, the Duke of Buckingham. And now you can ruin us all.
I beg your forgiveness. I love her. You know what it is to love, right? How can I risk my life to serve your words?
Follow us at distance at 20 paces, as far as the loop. If anyone spies, kill him.
Give me the papers.
Has Rochefort arrived yet?
No, monsieur.
When he does, tell him to come see me. Immediately.
Yes.
So, why are you here?
That is impossible for me to tell you because I don't know.
You are accused of high treason.
High treason? Me? How's it possible to portray a contestant even on an expanse? I swear, I know nothing of what has happened.
What has happened?
I don't know.
You have been accused of conspiring with your wife and the Duke of Buckingham.
A queen, a Spanish queen.
Quiet.
The Duke of... Me. Wait, I have heard my wife say that name.
On what occasion?
She said that Cardinal Richelieu had drawn the Duke of Buckingham to Paris to destroy him and ruin the queen.
She said that?
Yes, Monseigneur, but I told her she was wrong and that she thinks that His Eminence the Cardinal would never...
You're a fool.
That's what my wife said.
You have a wife?
Yes. This is saying I had one.
What have you done to have had one if you no longer have one?
They have abducted her.
Who has abducted her?
A tall, pale, noble man with an eye patch.
An eye patch? And his name?
I have no idea, but I recognize him among a thousand men.
You would recognize him?
That is to say, that is...
You have just told me that you would have recognized him.
But I don't...
Someone must be informed that you will recognize him.
But I don't know him.
Take him away.
Take me where? You're taking me home? You're sending me home?
Lock him in the dungeon.
My God! My wife has committed some terrible crime to confess. Women are so weak. The dungeon, then tomorrow's wheel, then the gallows. My God, have pity on me.
Where is your wife?
Abducted.
She escaped.
It's not my fault, I swear.
What business did you have with Monsieur d'Artagnan yesterday?
Ah, yes. Monsieur d'Artagnan. That is true. I do confess. I did go to his apartment to beg him to help me find my wife.
Liar! He fought with the guards when they attempted to arrest your wife. And now he has taken her somewhere.
Are you saying he has abducted her too?
Fortunately, d'Artagnan is in our midst today.
Bring in d'Artagnan!
Yes! Good. Confront me with him. I'll be happy to see him.
Monsieur d'Artagnan. What business did you have with Monsieur Bonachot yesterday?
But this is not D'Artagnan.
Well then, who is he?
I don't know.
What's his name?
Athos.
That's not the name of a man. That is the name of a mountain.
That is my name.
But you said your name was D'Artagnan?
I did.
Yes, you did.
Someone said to me, you are D'Artagnan? I answered, you think so? They declared they were sure of it. I didn't want to contradict them. I might have been mistaken.
You have some of my sweet justice.
I do?
You are D'Artagnan.
You see, you say it again.
D'Artagnan is a young man of 20. This man is at least 30.
Clearly, but where is this man's wife?
Shouldn't you ask the husband?
She is following the plans of a game worker.
I know nothing of what my wife does. And if she has committed a crime against the Cardinal, then I renounce her, I disown her, I curse her.
If you have no more need of me, take me somewhere. This man is a bore. Lock him in his cell. If it is D'Artagnan who is concerned in this matter, I do not see how I can take his place.
Lock him in the dungeon! Nothing stays in from the Cardinal!
In that case, can you ask him where my wife is?
Count Rochefort, Your Eminence.
Your Eminence?
Yep.
You are. And I. Oh my God. That's him.
Who?
The man who abducted my wife.
Take him away.
No. That's not him. This is another man who doesn't resemble him at all. This gentleman is honest, I'm sure, and would never abduct a man's wife.
You two, take him outside and hold him! last night. Who told you? Madame de Lannoy, who she voted to. Why didn't she let me know sooner? The queen mistrusted her and kept her all night and day.
The queen!
The queen! The queen! The evil!
Quiet! How long were they with each other?
1/4 of an hour. Did she return afterwards? Yes, we need to get a rose with the box from the mirror. When she returned, did she have this rosewood box? No.
What was in the rosewood box?
Diamond studs which His Majesty the King gave the queen on her birthday.
And Madame de Lannoy believes that the diamond studs are in the possession of the Duke?
Yes, she is sure.
Well, Rochefort, it looks like they have beaten us again.
They beat us! They beat us! We must take revenge!
I said be quiet! Never make me repeat myself!
We will have our revenge soon.
Bring in the prisoner!
Shall I search for the duck? That is you.
You're an idiot, but he is drunk.
You are the cardinal, the great cardinal, the man of genius, the whole world reveres.
Rise, my friend. You are a good man.
I have touched the hand of the cardinal. I have touched the hand of a great man. The great man has called me his friend.
I'm so sorry. You have been unjustly suspected of a crime you did not commit.
Please take this whole bag of 300 pistoles.
And please pardon me.
Pardon you? You are able to have me tortured, to have me hung. I cannot pardon you.
I have enjoyed your conversation. That's why I call on you so frequently.
Oh. I have enjoyed our conversation.
Goodbye, monsieur.
Goodbye.
Long life, Your Eminence. Long life, Your Eminence. Long life, Your Eminence.
He's ready.
I made him a spy on his wife. Go tell on him. Do not stop for anything. Deliver this to my lady.
Dear my lady, gather 200 pistoles from my treasury and attend the next ball by the Duke of Buckingham. He will wear a coat of diamond studs. Get as close to him as possible. And cut off two of them. When they are in your possession, inform me. I find out you stop for anything. Have you sent them steal?
Yeah.
travels to France.
Seven, 258. rise, my friend. But you abducted my wife. Here, take this purse and turn pistoles and pardon me. I will pardon you anything. Turn 59.
My good husband. There is a very active speed port and a great deal of money that can be made. Constance, I will give you a letter. You must not part with it until you deliver it.
Where?
London.
I warn you, I will not work in the dark again. I will know what I do and who I am doing it for.
An illustrious person sends you. The reward will surpass your expectation.
The Cardinal has warned me of these matters.
Have you seen the Cardinal?
He sent for me. He gave me his hand. He called me a friend. I'm a friend of the great Cardinal.
You serve the man who abducted your wife and mistreats your queen.
Private interests are nothing compared to the interests of the state.
You know nothing of the state. You take whatever side offers you most.
What do you say to this?
Where did you get that?
Can't you guess?
The Cardinal.
Yes, and my friend the Count de Rochefort.
He's the man who abducted me.
You told me yourself your abduction was entirely political.
To frighten me until I revealed secrets that would dishonor our queen.
Ha! The queen is a treacherous Spaniard. Whatever the Cardinal does is right.
I knew you were a coward and a miser, but I never thought you were a traitor.
They were going to torture me. Was it a wood I drew between your legs until the bones crack? Why don't you go yourself? Because I think I've been wrong about you. I believe you're a man, a violent man.
And you're a miserable, stupid woman. If you do not leave immediately, I'll have the queen arrest you and lock you in the Bastille.
I will appeal to the Cardinal.
You've become a cardinalist. He's bought you money. You've sold yourself to the devil.
To the Cardinal.
They're the same. Satan.
I see. Pardon me, my dear, but not knowing you were coming home, I made an appointment with a friend. As soon as I finish, I will come back and return you to the Louvre.
Thank you, but I'll return to the Louvre alone.
Very well. When will I see you?
I will be free again in the middle of next week.
I'll expect you then. Are you angry with me?
Not at all.
Then.
Excuse me, Dan, but you have a bad husband. Your husband is a fool, which is a misfortune, and you're in a difficult situation, which is fortunate for me because I can help you.
But the secret's not mine. I have no right to tell it.
You're about to tell it to your husband.
Not the full contents. Only enough to have him do what's necessary.
Can you not see that I love you?
I swear before God who hears us, that if you betray me and my enemies, pardon me, I will kill myself and accuse you of my death.
And I swear before God that if imprisoned while following the instructions you have given me, I would rather die than compromise anyone.
Then you must go immediately to London.
At once.
Perhaps you have no money,
but perhaps it's unnecessary.
Take this.
The money from the call.
That makes a respectable money.
It will be doubly amusing to save the queen if the call is money.
In the name of the queen, I forbid you to put yourself in any danger. That is not a perfect permission.
In your name, I will do as you say. Now you must go. Beautiful Constance, I will become worthy of your gratitude. But when I return, will I also become worthy of your love? Go.
My God, protect the queen and protect me.
My dear Athos,
pardon me, but who wrote you that letter?
The king's servant himself. It's in Jerry's hand, as you can see.
Begin again.
My dear Athos, I wish, as your health requires it, to rest for 2 weeks. Take the water or any place else that would be more agreeable, and heal as quickly as possible. Your affectionate, Dave Trevino. Can you explain this?
I explained this by saying, we must come
to the water forge.
There are many wars.
In the king's service?
The king's or the queen's.
A pardieu! Now, here's a strange thing. Since when in Musketeers do they grant men leave with their absence without their request?
Since your friends ask for them.
Ah,
it appears something is wrong. We'll go.
Where?
Ask D'Artagnan.
To London. Why are we going to London?
Ask D'Artagnan.
I can't tell you.
Ah, intrigue. And whom is it concern?
Ask D'Artagnan.
I can't tell you.
Excellent. But to go to London, we'll need money.
And I haven't.
Nor I.
I have 300 pistoles.
Ah, more intrigue. And where did he get it? Ask D'Artagnan. I can't tell you.
Of course. We should make 75. That will be enough to get to London and back. But we may not know why for that.
Why so?
Some of us may fall on the way.
If I risk my life, I would like to know what I'm dying for.
It will not help.
I share Porthos's opinion. We should know.
Does the king give you reasons? Gentlemen, he says, there's a war in Gascony or Flanders. Go and fight. And you go. And here are our 3 leagues of absences, which came from our captain, and 300 pistoles, which came from I don't know where. Let us go and get killed. Is life really worth the trouble of all these questions?
Well said, Athos. You don't speak often, but when you do, it's like St. John of Golden.
To Calais. It is the most direct route to London. We'll have to craft travel here because I cannot make 3 copies of the letter. If I fall, no king has stayed. If he falls, then it will be another man's turn. All that is necessary is for one of us to go to London. Let's go. I love you and your friends, right?
Pardon.
I will cut your ears off!
Ha ha ha.